Hello there. Welcome back to Drawing 101. This is Lesson 7, Gesture, the Line of Action. So far in our lessons, we've focused on angles and contour. These tools are used to help learn proportion, to help to learn to see. But essentially what you're doing is copying what you see. You're looking at something and looking at the relationships and going through every nook and cranny with contour to really get exactly what it is that you see. This is something that is very useful for illustration, for realistic type of work. And these things definitely can build a foundation, and as you absorb them, they become intuitive and you begin to see the world differently using these tools. However, their focus is different than the focus of gesture. The focus for gesture is not on exactly what something looks like. You're not copying, but you're looking for the feeling, the essence of a pose, the feeling of the movement within something. So often gesture is used to draw living things, such as the figure or animals. It can even be used for trees if you're capturing the feeling of the way the tree's branches and the way its trunk moves. It can even be used for non-living things, buildings for example, if you want to bring character or personality. Gesture drawing is really the core or the foundation for hand-drawn animation, and it's a way to describe, by using a still image, to describe movement. Today, we're going to start with gesture in a simple form, starting simple and then getting more specific, just like we did with angles. And we are going to focus on the line of action. And the line of action is one line that is used to describe the essence of the pose and the direction of the pose and what it feels like just with one line. So I'm going to show you some examples. Let's get to work. All right, so here are the examples I was showing you. Just want to make it clear. And we're going to look at each of these and see the line of action. So we're looking to follow the direction of how this person is moving. So here's Matt Damon. See the line of action. These two soccer players moving. Basketball players, similar type of movement. You notice how there's no straight lines. Tiger Woods. Tiger Woods, and Shawshank Redemption, and to see it even clearer, there you go. So those are examples of the line of action. All right, so if I would draw these, let's start with Tiger Woods, that one line of action. It's not ever going to be a straight line, which is boring. But it's going to be a strong line that is showing movement. So there's Tiger. Looking down here to the basketball player, we're looking to follow this movement. One line, and you see how one line, I'm sort of going over it a couple times, so you get more than a line, but one main direction that you are drawing. And over here to Mr. Damon. So you can see it's very, very simple. That's it. And this is going to be a foundation for what we will build on next week. So let me give you a few more examples here. All right, some more examples. Here we have from The Shawshank Redemption, which is an excellent movie. This movement going from going backwards as he's leaning backwards. So we want to mimic that line, describing this line of action. These two soccer players, we can do both of them. We have one guy really leaning this way. You can see how his whole body is leaning. And this guy, same type of thing. Maybe not quite as curved, but Those are our lines of action. Now, the reason I included this image, because he is not moving, so it makes it more difficult to see exactly what to draw, and we can't really get it exactly with just one line. We'd have to begin trying to see his top of his body, and then his legs sort of are going in different ways. So you see why the line of action is really for movement, when a person is doing something, leaning back, they're running in action.
All right, so good luck this week with your assignment, and just keep in mind for drawing the line of action that it's fast and it's about feeling it. So have fun and see you next week.